you find the place okay, yeah?
Yeah.
Travel was okay.
See?
You got
see?
The bus.
See?
Number 17.
Discover Dundee.
Yeah.
Discover Dundee bus.
Have you been on the tourist bus yet?
No.
Don't bother, right? Because, like, I hate this. For those of you that know the tourist bus in Dundee, it starts at, you know, the Discovery, the boat?
See?
Yeah, yeah.
See?
So you start on there and you go past the McManus Museum, which is very nice. If you've not been there, you should go. It's really cool. And you just go up, right up to the law, the top of the hill, and you get some nice tourist photo opportunities. And then you just come back down the way, and then you, basically where you came, and then you go over the bridge to kind of like halfway between Newport and Tayport. And then you get to take more photos of Dundee from the other side. Well, it's nice, yeah. But then you come back to Discovery and that's it. There's so much of the city the tourist bus ignores. So, Tremendo, I will give you Patrick's own personal tour of Dundee. So, and then you'll get the proper experience. But, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Welcome back to the SCW podcast. I am your host, Patryk Peterski, flying solo for this episode. But not completely alone. I have my guest, my new friend, my new amigo, El Tremendo. Welcome to the podcast.
Hola, señor Patrick. Yes. I love you, man.
Now, you know what? I am very glad that I've managed to get you on here because, for those of you who don't know, El Tremendo came over to DAPW, the Dundee Nangers Pro Wrestling School to train. What was it? Sort of end of May, start of June, sort of start of summertime. You've come over from Spain. Where was this place that you were telling me exactly where you were from? Because like, it's not just Malaga, but it's like a little town sort of in that area. Right? No, and I'll murder the pronunciation, so I'm gonna let you do it.
Cuevas de San Marcos.
Yes, which is in the province of Malaga, which is what, southern Spain. I'm just getting the map out here. Yes. We're a lot of people in this country like to go on holiday. But yeah, so it's amazing to have somebody from that part of the world over here. As you know, we've got some representation from all around Europe now. You've got myself from over in Poland. Jay Robbins got his roots in Poland and a bit of Italian in there as well. You know, we've yet to see that from Jay one day. I need him to bring out the Italian charisma one day. And then we've got yourself from Spain, so we're all over Europe. And for those of you that have been paying attention to the galas in particular, over the summer we've been in Brechin, we've been in Perth, we've been in Dundee, we've been in Errol, been all over Tayside, all over Dundee and Angus, and sort of Perthshire area as well. You have been tearing it up on the gala scene this year.
Gracias.
And that culminated for me when I think it was in North Muton, which is that area of Perth that we did a show in. We saw the debut of the Europapa Union. the union that nobody knew that they needed until now. Because not only did I get to tag with one of my new friends, we got to come out to the... my opinion, the best ever Eurovision song ever. Which didn't even make it to the final, sadly, because of other reasons. But we're not going into that. What I want to talk about first, El Tremendo, before we plug this month's shows, because we've got two big ones to plug this
big month, man.
We've got a show at the Tulloch coming up very soon. As time of recording, I think it's a week on Friday, isn't it? It is. I should have had this prepared before we started, Patrick. I've been doing this long enough now.
Friday, 13th. Bad day for body guy Brandon.
Oh, we'll get into that later, don't worry. Yeah, you're right, of course. Thank you for keeping me right, Tremendo. I'm lost on doing this on my own, but there you go, I've got a pal now. Friday the 13th at the Tulloch Institute in Perth, we've got the next Tulloch show for FCW, and then we're going to talk about the big one, the big Dundee show of the year. Saturday, September 28th is ArdlerMania Part Deux. So we got Poland, we got Spain, and we got some French. And so there we go, we're representing all across the
beautiful
world.
Beautiful continent, yeah. Beautiful Europe. I love it.
You're a bit of France.
Nice. Paris, yeah. Marseille.
I really want to go to Marseille. Oh. What's Marseille like?
Monaco. Monaco, yeah.
Did you go over for the Grand Prix, the racing?
No.
The chicas, yes. What are the Monegasque chicas like?
Very rich, very rich.
Did they look after you, yeah?
I see. What a bomb.
Right now I'm wishing this was a visual podcast as well with the things that Tremendo were just in. But yeah, before we get kicked off air, so I want to know a bit more about you. Like, for the viewers, the listeners want to know a little bit more about who exactly is El Tremendo. Tell me, how did you get your start? I'm going to do that old cliched wrestling podcast question, but how you got into wrestling, how did it start? Because Billy does it on the main feed. You've not had the honour of being on there yet. Maybe one day though, Billy, get El Tremendo on the big podcast. But tell us, how did El Tremendo, give us a backstory to El Tremendo. How did you get here to the brink of your FCW debut?
Big fan of wrestling. Grown up, yeah. I loved wrestling. I love it.
Who was your favourite wrestler grown up?
Kane. Yes.
Why Kane?
See, he's Spanish.
He's from Spain. Now, a lot of people don't know this, but
greatest luchador of all time.
Kane was an Air Force baby. I know this. This is one of my wrestling fun facts that I like to pull out in quizzes and stuff. But yeah, Kane was born in Spain.
Not a lot of people know that, but Kane, Spanish, and now he is mayor of some American
Tennessee somewhere.
President of Spain. Yeah.
And that's the funny thing, because he wasn't born in America, he can't actually be president of America. That's a fact.
Army.
Yeah, exactly. And see, this is what happens when you tune into the FCW podcast. You get some knowledge on the rules of American politics. That is what everyone tunes in for. But yeah, Kane, so and obviously from your home country, a luchador like yourself with a mask, is that maybe one of the reasons why you maybe wanted to follow in those footsteps as well?
It's a great tradition. In Spain, and of course Mexico, and Rey Mysterio, guys like that. I just loved wrestling. As soon as I saw it, I watched it, I was so excited. I just thought, what is this? It's like they're fighting, but there's drama, the story. Ah, love it. It's the greatest sport in the world.
Yeah.
Better than football.
Yeah.
For these fake football players. Oh.
I think you're quite good at football. I know that you're maybe not a football guy, but thank you for being angled in the Euro final. I was Spanish that night. I was drinking a lot of Estrella that night.
Estrella. Yeah. Yes. Football. Never my thing. Malaga tried to sign me up, but no, not my thing. I didn't want to play with Ruud van Nistelrooy at the time, but
they were really good like 10 years ago. I think the money kind of ran out.
The money wasn't right, so I chose wrestling.
Yeah. Well, I think you made the right decision, because we got a very decent win on that gala for those that came out. We are now undefeated as a tag team. But yeah, so I'm looking forward to seeing this growth from you continue, my friend. It's been a fun ride so far.
Gracias.
So I'm glad you're getting an opportunity on the main roster. And you know what? Should we just jump in and talk about that right now? I think that's a good idea. So we're going to go through the cards for these upcoming shows as we normally do. And as we mentioned earlier on, the first one is on Friday the 13th at the Tulloch Institute in Perth. And if you get yourselves along to Tulloch bright and early, you are going to see the debut of my friend El Tremendo is taking on Body Guy Brandon in a special pre-show match that is starting a wee bit early. Our shows normally start around 7 o'clock. But doors open at 6:30 as normal. Make sure you get in early, because at about 6:45, you are going to hit the ring and hopefully teach this twat that Body Guy Brandon is a bit of a lesson.
Him and I had a match at Gala, and the match never finished. It never finished. One-on-one interference that really upset me. So I wanted rematch.
I wanted it.
Body Guy, I don't think he wants it, but I don't blame him. I got it all. So
I mean, this is a big deal for him as well, because this is his FCW debut. He's been on the APW shows before. So a big opportunity for both of you, but I'm glad that you're getting this shot, because like you said, you had him that day, if it wasn't for like, when you got a win by disqualification. See? That's not what you want. You want to pin or submit him, yeah? And that's what I'd be feeling about you.
He was going to tap. He was going to tap from the ankle lock, but you know, I will get it. I will get it. Listen, I respect Brandon. I respect him as a competitor, but he gone down, man. Yeah. He gone down.
He's very arrogant, despite everyone that.
And I'm happy.
He shouldn't be
and I'm happy he's getting this opportunity. As well, but because it's taken him a while as well, that night will be my night.
Yeah,
it will not be an unlucky 13.
Yes,
be a lucky 13.
This is hopefully going to be the first step on your journey, maybe even towards like a junior title run. Is this like something, a goal you've got? Like, what are your goals now that you're here in FCW?
Well,
that might be the most obvious like division to go into, the junior heavyweight division. Would you style? Would you leave your style?
See,
but tell me what you're thinking. What are your plans and goals for FCW after you've dealt with what to get around?
I think it is just about taking it one match at a time, trying to get as much wins under my belt. And then, eventually wear the big belt. And you got to aim high in life. Yeah. You got to aim high, I'm aiming high. But I am very focused on this match coming up. Mm. Very focused, and then I focus on the next one, and then the next one.
Not getting too ahead of yourself.
And just concentrate on the wings, and if it... I have a plan for a year, 2 years, I do want to have a belt, but I need to earn it. I will train hard, and I will work hard, and it will happen.
Yeah.
It
you have been training hard, I'm seeing it, when we were at sessions together,
Grazie,
see. Speaking of Italian as well, grazie.
Gracias, the Spanish.
Yeah.
Spanish. Costa del Sol, man. Yes.
But yes, right. So with I'm glad. You know what? You're probably right. That's probably the best way to look at it. Like, maybe I've been guilty before of thinking, right, this is what I want, but I need to figure out like what's in front of me right now and get that. It's probably a sensible attitude to have. So that's something I can take from you and learn from. It means there have been situations in the past where you've maybe thought, I've had this ultimate goal and I want to do anything that can I can to get there, but maybe you've taken shortcuts or whatever, and then you think, right, I can't do that again in the future.
Because
I know I have.
That's...
I know, I'm asking big questions.
Good question. Very philosophical.
Yeah.
I think so. So it's all about the what is it they say over here? The journey.
Yeah,
the journey.
Yeah, not the destination.
Yes. It's not about the destination, the end result. This is about the journey and enjoying it. And right now, I have enjoyed. I love Scotland. I love it. I've enjoyed the galas. It has been. Amazing journey for me so far. I'm loving it. Loving it. And that's it. I just stop and smell the roses, you know, and enjoy the whole thing. So I think so. If anyone listening out there, that's how I treat life, and I would recommend. I'm very good place right now.
Good. That's good to hear, Tremendo. And I can't, before we go on, I can't not mention you turned up at Wembley last week. So like it was the surprise guest guys, we've got a surprise and it was you. I was so happy that you were able to like come down and spend the rest of the show, because you got there just on time.
I got on the bus from Dundee to Edinburgh and ended up in London. I don't know. The crazy bus driver. We had too much tequila, so there we go. Tremendous event.
Yeah.
I got to meet my friend Patryk. I got to meet you. It was fantastic. Great. We had good time.
Good time in London afterwards. Yeah, it was good.
Love it. Love London. Love London. Not as good as Scotland.
Obviously not. But yeah, so things have been good. I think this is going to be the kickstarter for you, my friend, to get you better. Gracias. So I'm looking forward to it.
And for you, my friend, and for you, I'm so grateful for everything, all the opportunities, I hope that one day you and I can team together again.
We're guys from similar situations in that, like, you know, you've come over to a new place, so I'm trying. Right. Well, what would I have liked when I came over? So that's what I'm trying to give to you. Yeah. This is why I'm going to give you the nice tour of Dundee and all that as well. So, yeah, we've got to stick together, man. Right. So should we talk about some more wrestling?
Absolutely.
Because you're going to walk over Body Guy, and you know what? I might even come down to ringside and watch it with you. I think I'd enjoy that.
I would love that.
I'd quite like to get a front row view of this.
I would love that.
So we're going to go through the rest of the card for September 13th. This is one I want to talk about. One of the big, probably the biggest match of the night, arguably. Title match. Tag Team Championships. Yeah, I've got Sebastian Asher and Duke from DE defending the titles against Kasuna Brutale, who's made up, of course, of Rabu and Mikey Devine. Mikey Devine won the shot for his team in a triple threat match last month. Great match.
Good match. Good match.
And now he's got to deal with two men that I'm very familiar with. I've had a lot of altercations with both of them in the last year. Nearly won the tag team titles from them a week after they won them, a few months ago in Tape Up. But it didn't quite work out that in the end. And despite me having been involved in title matches against them, I would probably say this is actually their biggest test so far in Casino Brutale. One of the best up-and-coming teams in Scotland. Recently won their first piece of tag team silverware in a different company over on the West Coast. So they're not strangers to gold. So they're looking to add the FCW titles to their collection. So a potentially daunting task for Sebastian and Duke. And they've been, in my opinion, scraping by some matches by using their underhanded tactics. You know, I've talked to Def before on this podcast how much I rate Sebastian Asher in particular as an amazing all-round wrestler, but he always relies on his brass knucks, he always relies on his low blows. Duke, again, is one of the greatest minds I've ever seen in wrestling. But again, he takes shortcuts, he cuts corners, he doesn't let his ability in that ring do the talking. He always has to try and weasel his way into cheap victories, in my opinion, which is not something I want to do. I want to earn everything that I earn in wrestling rather than you know, get there by nefarious ways. So it always frustrates me that they insist on doing that, but you know, if anyone can overcome that, I think it's Rabu and I think it's Mikey.
Casino Brutale. I've admired them. I've been watching for years. Admire them both. Great competitors. I just think that ED. They are those kind of competitors that use everything to their disposal. People like you and I, we have to look out for that. We got eyes in the back of our head. And Casino Brutale have to adapt that as well. They have to be ready. Prediction? Do you have a prediction?
I think that these guys are on a roll, Casino Brutale. I think it's going to be very tough to stop them. And like I said, I think Duke and Asher might be living on borrowed time already. I wouldn't be shocked if Casino Brutale come away with a win here. I would put money on it, going for their gambling theme, because it was also one of the best names in Scottish wrestling, let's be honest. It wouldn't shock me at all if Casino Brutale come out on top. I'm pulling for them.
Yeah.
I want those titles off those two.
Sebastian's not Marcus. What? I mumbled. Sorry, did you not pick that up?
No.
Was it a bit? Sorry. What did I say? Sebastian and Asher, and I think they just have the edge. I think they're on a roll as well. Wow, what a year they are having. So I'm going to say Duke and Asher.
Fair enough. Right, what next? We've got, now this is an interesting contest to say the least. we have got Ewan G. Market.
I love
it. Yes. Big fan of Ewan, yeah?
Yes, again, for years I've admired him.
You get a lot of Scottish wrestling over in Malaga, yeah? I didn't know that. We've been reaching that far. We're just on YouTube, yeah?
YouTube, yeah.
YouTube, yeah.
It's been, we call it YouTube.
Well, fair enough. But yes, he is taking on Bruiser Brad Evans, the third member of the Foundation of the Future. A daunting task, to say the least, Tremendo.
Size difference. Size. Bruiser could crash. Ewan, but he tough little dude.
Ewan is tough, man. He's not exactly a stranger to coming up against men that are like twice his size, so it's like, I guess war off a duck's back to Ewan at this point.
I think
what he celebrated is, was it 17 years earlier this year, I think. I can't remember. Forgive me, Ewan, if I've got that wrong, but you've been doing this for a long time and it shows because you're excellent in the ring. I've been in the ring with Ewan a couple of times and you always learn. You always learn a lot because he's got all that experience and he uses it. He's another one. This is the thing about Ewan. He can use everything to his advantage, but in a positive way. Maybe other than Asha and Juk. But, I mean, Brad's going to be not a happy bunny because, of course, Zach Dynamite was representing the Foundation in that triple threat match we talked about earlier on. Didn't get the job done. So, Foundation don't have a title shot in Tulloch. I worry for Ewan that Brad might try and take that out, that frustration out on Ewan.
And sometimes the emotion can get the better of him, so he got to control that.
Yeah.
He got to control that. Don't be angry. Yeah. Got to think.
Yeah.
Got to stay minded.
Yeah.
Stay minded.
Is that something you always try and, you know, make sure that you don't get your emotions and keep them in check?
Stay minded.
Yeah. It's just like something that like training would have focused on like back in Spain, yeah?
You know what we call it?
What's that?
Stay-minded.
Okay.
Stay-minded.
Yeah. What was training like? Like, what's the differences you've had like from training in Malaga to training in Arbroath in the APW?
It is hotter.
What, in Arbroath?
Very, very sweaty. Very sweaty in Malaga. But, you learn something different from everyone that you work with, everyone that you train with. Up here in Scotland, all the trainers are different as well in their approaches. I think so, there's similarities but differences.
Okay.
That makes sense.
I get you. You asked me, I'm going to ask you this time. You got any predictions for...
Predictions? You've got experience.
Mm.
You know, 17 years. Mm. And just a big, bad dude. Might be, if he shows up, he might be pissed. Bruiser Brad.
You're gonna go for Brad? You know what? We're gonna disagree again. I'm gonna go for Ewan. I'm gonna back Ewan. I think he's got the know-how to get this. And Ewan's one of the best wrestlers in the company.
He's
former champion as well, former SW champion. I think he's gonna cause a few people's equipments to go bust, I think. I think Ewan will get this one.
He's tough dude.
But what's the way to find out, Tremendo?
You got to attend.
Yeah, you got to attend. You got to go to ticketsource.co.uk/FCW and get your tickets. That is the best way to find out. So what have we got next? Now this one. I've been looking forward to this one. Retro Randy himself is taking on Redgate's Samuel in a one-on-one contest. Now, as you know, I know a thing or two about Redgate and how dangerous they are. I went to war with them over the summer in more ways than one. Samuel is a dangerous man, even by Redgate standards. He has this mist that he whacks out when he feels he needs to. It put me in hospital for weeks, and it was not fun. I nearly lost sight in my right eye, or if it was my left eye, I can't even remember. I try not to think about it. It was horrible. And this is of course around the time we were meeting as well, because you just come over and like, it was nice when all that was over and we got to get a bit closer and spend a bit more time together. But they're not nice people. I worry for Randy because I know how dangerous they are. You don't know who's lurking in the back, because the thing I've not always considered, and I've thought about it more maybe since I'm not in the eye of the storm of Red Gate anymore, you don't know how many people are in there.
No.
Like, we only know of so many that have come to the forefront. Christ knows how many are actually involved behind the scenes. So you not only have to look out for the members that you know exist, but anytime anyone could pop up. And it's something that freaks me out about Red Gate, because you just don't know. There's so little we know about them.
A lot of mystery clouding over the Red Gate, and that can be, you just don't know what to expect. That is what's scary. But I agree. Samuel, dangerous human being, if he is human, I don't know. But Red Joe Randy, I rock it all over the world.
And you know what, he's looking real jacked in this promo photo that we're looking right now.
He's looking
good, baby.
He is good. Again, you've got lots of experience there. It is going to be a very good match. It is going to be interesting what kind of Samuel shows up on today.
I think a motivated Samuel. I think as much as I love Randy, I worry for him, because again, all these cockroaches could come sliding out from under the stone when you lift them up. And if I'm putting money on it, I might have to go with Samuel. I think this could be a big coming out night for Samuel, announcing himself on the stage here at FCW. But I just hope Randy's going to be okay at the end of it. If Randy survives this match, he's doing all right, in my opinion, because I know what it's like being in there with Randy.
You know, and that match, oh, wow, amazing match. You overcome the powers of the Red Gate, and that is a tough asking. We teamed against and very tough individual, and I think we're going to this, but I just think that Randy just has got he has some immortal powers.
Yeah. The power of Retromania, that's what it is.
And I just think that he has got something better to offer.
Yeah.
And I go to win for Randy.
Okay, well, again, we'll see what happens.
We disagree again.
It's a bit of friendly discussion. Yeah? It's good. It's good when you can agree to disagree, yeah?
That's good.
What have we got next? Now, I love the way this has been marketed by the SCW marketing team. So we have Caleb Valhalla, the mighty Caleb Valhalla, former multiple-time SCW heavyweight champion, taking on the SCW junior heavyweight champion, Spike Tierney. And the tagline for this match is non-title match, brackets, obviously. Because, Caleb is no junior heavyweight. But
no.
The reason, and we're going to speak very briefly as to why this match is a non-title match, because the one match, as we currently speak so far, that has been announced for ArdlerMania Part 2, which again, you can get your tickets at on ticketsource.co.uk/FCW. You can get them on faircitywrestling.co.uk as well. A match has been signed for that show, and Spike Tierney is going to defend his FCW Junior Heavyweight Championship against Ravy Davey. the fresh Prince of Drumline Square himself. And TikTok superstar. I believe we're legally obligated to mention that he's a TikTok superstar as well.
See?
We have to mention that.
See?
Yeah. What's Spanish TikTok like?
Talk tech,
right, okay. it's like arm drags. Everyone is reversed in Spain. Yeah.
I'm drag.
I'll show you later.
Draw drag arm.
Yeah, drag. Yes. I walked right into that one. But yeah, so Ravy Davey is making his SCW debut against Spike Tierney, which will be a very, very entertaining match, I'm sure.
To the
most prominent wrestlers in the country right now. Spike's on the run of a lifetime.
See.
Yeah. Davey's making waves with his company CPW over in Glasgow. So yeah, it's like two of the biggest names in the country going out head to head on our biggest show in Dundee of the year. So it's fantastic.
Spike Dimney, we love him. We love him in Spain, but recently, not with the black. We don't like that. We are disappointed as a nation. And
you hear that, Spike? The whole Spain is disappointed.
He's up there with England. No one likes him.
Wow. What statement? But I mean, like, this is going to be interesting now with Spike, because he's essentially beaten everyone there is to beat, arguably, in the junior heavyweight division now. I guess he would definitely say he has, because he was able to overcome Nitro Green, the one man that he hadn't successfully pinned in the championship match. I mean, he did get a bit of help from his stablemates in DE, but, you know. So now, SCW have thrown in this curveball of, right, okay, you think you're better than all the junior heavyweights, well, let's take on the most successful heavyweight in company history and see how you get on.
And maybe it is the kind of challenge that he needs.
Yeah, yeah.
That he needs to progress. Yeah.
There's always a bigger fish. Kale Valhalla's a big fish.
Big fish.
He's a real big fish. He's like, also a big bump.
Loch Ness monster.
Yeah. Well, have you been up there yet? Have you been up to Loch Ness?
Yeah, I bet it's nasty.
See, people don't think he's real.
Oh, he's real.
And those people are just going on the wrong day.
He's real.
Big boy. He's not as big as Caleb.
But
Spike going 1-on-1 with Caleb, like, only, what, a couple of weeks before Ravy Davey. Ravy Davey's got to be loving that, because that might potentially soften him up.
And that'll be tough to recover for Spike. I'm excited, genuinely, for me
this is like one of the biggest treats that we could give to the fans, because it's again probably the most successful junior heavyweight in company history. He's had that title for over a year and a half now. He's had that title. You've got Caleb, who's, I believe, he's the longest reigning champion. He's also got multiple reigns. I don't think anyone else has had multiple reigns with the SCW heavyweight title. So arguably, the two most successful people ever to wrestle in FCW are wrestling 1-on-1. And what's not to love about that?
It is going to be one for the crowd.
Yeah. The real winners are the fans.
Yeah.
And hopefully, Ashel, Duke, and Atlas stay out of it and let Caleb and Spike give us the match
that we all want to see.
Right, and we've talked about it. And then he gets through Caleb and he's got to deal with Ravy Davey, who it can be unpredictable. So I don't envy Spike in that regard. But this is what happens when you're an FCW junior heavyweight champion. You've got to take on all these challenges that come in front of you. Now, speaking of championships, and speaking of championship matches that are there, this just got, on the day of recording, this just got announced today. We are seeing the return of two very impressive ladies to FCW. Kate Calloway has been signed to take on Moxie Malone in a number one contendership match at the Talk Show on Friday the 13th. The winner of this match gets the championship match against Brody Adler at what she's going to be calling, I'm sure, ArdlerMania part two. Yeah, so the winner of Calloway versus Moxie Malone is getting a shot at Brody at ArdlerMania part two. These are two of my favourite female wrestlers in the country. I was very impressed with what I saw from Kate. She made her debut in Tapo a couple of months ago. Mm-hmm. Came up short that night against Brody, but gave a very, very good account of herself. I've seen what she's been doing over at Power Pro as well. I've seen a few of her matches, some clips from her matches over the summer. She's looking even better than what she was when she was in FCW. So making a return to FCW is very exciting. We're going to see an even better version of Kate than what we did before. And against Moxie Malone, who's just making waves everywhere. And every time she's been in FCW, she's looked fantastic.
Mm.
So you just know again that this version of Moxie is going to be even better than the last one we saw. So whoever wins this match and advances to ArdlerMania, Brody's got a tough task on her hands.
I agree with everything you just said there. I think it could be one of the most exciting women's wrestling matches that FCW has ever seen.
I think it's what they call in Scotland, Tremendo, a sleeper hit. It's like it's maybe a match you're going to turn up, and that this could be the one that you're talking about.
See,
walking out of the building.
See, like, see. Two great competitors. I think it's going to be a great match. Both very talented. Both are got so much to look forward to in their careers.
Yeah.
And it is very tough to decide though.
Yeah.
But I agree. I think this could be the match that everyone is talking about afterwards. Yeah. And it's maybe not the match that you are thinking before, this is the one, but it's got the makings of a classic.
Yeah. I'm looking forward for Kate to get the Empire Zone debut, because she made her debut in Tapot. Great crowd in Tapot, of course, but as we know, Tulloch crowds, maybe you might not always be able to make the journey over to Tapot. So for a lot of our fans, this might be the first taste of Kate Calloway. You're gonna get your money's worth.
See,
I won't be seeing Kate. Kate's fantastic, and she's only going to get even better every time she's back in FCW. So fingers crossed she keeps coming back.
And the Tulloch crowd are different.
Yeah.
They're louder. No offense to Tabort, but the Tulloch crowd. So that could play a big part in such a young woman's inexperienced career.
Gets the crowd on her side, you know, get the money there.
Yeah.
Help, maybe gives you that extra 10%.
Yeah. So Moxie for me, I think she just has the edge. I think that she's just got a little bit more, a little bit more experience. Mm. And years, she's been around now and got the scene for a number of years now. Someone I have had an eye on scouting and that. But anyway, that is a different story. So
a
great prospect. So I'm going to say Moxie Malone.
Go on, Kate. Do it. I'm backing you. Do it for the underdogs. but like I said, whoever Brody faces, Brody knows she's going to have her hands full. Either it's going to be a rematch with Kate, or it's going to be a match with Moxie Malone for the championship. So again, either way, we are the winners as fans of this show. So I'm looking forward to that. And I believe we have got one more order of business, Tremendo, to talk about tonight. And that is the state of the FCW Heavyweight title. We know that Ian Ambrose won a hellacious number one contenders match last month at the Tulloch against Looking Sharp. The winner of that match, it was one of those... I wasn't able to make that show, I'm afraid. It was no holds barred. No disqualification. One of those things that means the same thing.
Death match.
Officially, it wasn't a death match.
It wasn't, but the referee was blind at that time.
It was crazy.
Chris Quinn
love his eyes. I love Chris Quinn.
Yeah, his long hair got in his eyes that night.
It's getting longer. It's getting longer. I didn't realise he was bald by choice before. He's like, have you heard of Scott Brown?
Scott Brun.
Yeah, yeah. He's from a place called Dunfermline.
Yeah. Oh, never heard of it.
Yeah. No, but yeah. So for years he was like this, like very hard footballer that always like shaved his hair, but nobody really knew he was shaving his hair. Everyone just thought he was bald. And then all of a sudden he stopped playing, and then he had hair. And everyone was like, "What? You're bald by choice." This is Chris Quinn for me. I'm like, oh, you're like...
He's Scott Brun.
The Scott Brown of refereeing.
Scott Brun.
Yeah.
For hell of beef.
Yeah. What?
What? Sorry, did they not pick up again?
You're starting to pick up a wee accent here. Like, this is what happens when you learn English. Like,
I can.
In Scotland.
I can.
you get the wee accent, man.
I'm man.
Well, mine's gone. I came over when I was quite young. So, like, any remnants of Krakow is kind of gone in my voice. But that happened. So you've only been here, what, five months, something, not even that long.
Aye.
But it's creeping in, stop it. It's creeping in already. We've got a show to promote, Tremendo, come on, man. Right, one more push. We've got Ian Ambrose, won his match against Looking Sharp. He is in the title match to crown a new champion, ArdlerMania Part 2. We don't know who his opponent's going to be. And we still don't know his opponent to be. Again, on the day of recording, we got some breaking news. FCW has announced that we do have an opponent for Ian Ambrose, ArdlerMania, but they have sort of, I don't know if they've like used some sort of lawyers to get some sort of like thing added into their contract, but they have been told that they will not reveal who they are. right? All we know is that the match is going to take place at ArdlerMania, and that Ian Ambrose's opponent's identity will remain a secret until a contract signing that's going to take place at the show on September 13th. So we've got an FCW title contract signing for the ArdlerMania event, Part 2 event on the 28th at Dundee. That's taking place at the Tulloch Institute on September 13th.
Why though? Why not tell us? Why keep it secret? It must be someone. Someone big. I mean, the match, infamous Ian Ambrose, great match. Great match with Luke King Sharp, who was Luke King Sharp that night. And he just did a great match. I really enjoyed it. It was lots of like weapons being used. And he did, Ian, I admire Ian Ambrose. But I asked that question, why keep it a secret? Yeah. Why is it such a mystery? Have you got any clues who it could be?
I mean, I'd be lying if I said I knew, or if I even had that much of an idea. I mean,
it's you.
I mean, there's some people like throwing hints out, like Retro Randy's commented on it here saying he's going to be pretty tired from throwing Samuel around, but he'll have the energy to sign a contract, so could it be Randy? Yunji Maki simply putting Target acquired. So, I don't know, I don't want to speculate too much because I'll probably just look silly if I come up with all these like amazing theories about who it could be and who it couldn't be, and then it turns out to be nothing to do with that. But again, I'll say earlier on, what's the best way to find out, Tremendo? Go to ticketsource.co.uk.
Go to Ticketsource and then show up on the Friday, the 13th of September at the Tulloch Institute in Perth, Scotland, not Australia. No. I made that mistake once.
Oh no.
I still had a good time.
Did you end up at the WWE show then as well? Did you just accidentally get on like various forms of public transport and end up at massive stadium shows?
There you go.
Confirmation that you were at, was that Elimination? Yeah, it was Elimination Chamber earlier.
See.
So you've done Elimination Chamber and All In this year.
See.
That's not bad.
See. Aye.
Right, everyone now needs to look out for El Tremendo at like any big, like the Raw, and you're going to be in the Raw Rumble, aren't you? That's going to be the hat trick. You're going to show up at that show by accident because you get on the wrong plane, and you'll end up walking backstage. There's a surprise entrant with El Tremendo from FCW.
See?
Right, I'm calling it now. I'm putting £10 on El Tremendo to win the Royal Rumble. WrestleMania next year.
I will get there. Me and Cody Rhodes, if he's still champion.
Well, I was going to say it. I'm going to go to end this, right? To end this, let's for a laugh say El Tremendo wins the Royal Rumble. You've got a choice. You can go after, currently the champions are, well, Cody Rhodes got the WWE title, but you've got Gunther, fellow European man, the World Heavyweight Champion. Who are you going after?
Gunther, he would just eat me up. He'd just choppy
choppy your chest.
So there's nothing left to chop. Cody Rhodes, just technically amazing. Amazing. So much. It's in his blood. It's in his blood.
Literally.
But literally, yeah. Literally.
How much adrenaline is in your soul?
I don't know. But what I would say is I will see what happens after the Royal Rumble once I win it.
What's your head?
You know, I beat Gunther on a Friday, I beat Cody Rhodes on a Saturday.
Oh, you're going to beat them both?
I beat them both at the same time on a Sunday.
Well, I can't think of any better way to end this episode of the podcast with El Tremendo. Thank you for joining me. I thought I was going to. I've really enjoyed it.
Gracias.
And I look forward. We're going to do this, yeah? I'll come out to the ring with you.
Deal.
Right, so until then, like I said, we'll plug the shows again. ticketsource.co.uk/FCW. Get your tickets for Tulloch on Friday the 13th, and get your tickets for ArdlerMania in Dundee at the Ardler Complex on the 28th. I've been your host, Patryk Peterski. This has been my guest,
El Tremendo.
Yes, and we will see you soon. So SmackDown, right? SmackDown, you'd beat Cody, is that right? Because he's a SmackDown guy.
Uh-huh.
And then on the Saturday night of WrestleMania, you'd take on Gunther. and then you take his title. So you're already a double champion at this point. And just to flex on both of them on the Sunday, you give them both a rematch in the same match. And then you beat them both.
Did they both need to beat them both at the same time?
Wow. I can't wait for that. If Triple H is listening, then think about it.